Again, it was proved to me that I'm not among the good looking girls. And she just casually told me that तू बचपन में तो गोरी थी, अभी कैसे काली हो गई? And recall those memories of being mocked at. I just felt very embarrassed as people have a habit of, you know, being the fashionist and there is something wrong with me. And so when Krishna's song itself is there where he calls himself dark, I don't know what logic those girls use. Don't wear white, that will make you look more dark. As if I can. How come her hand looks more good when she wears red nail polish? Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Annie. I hope you all are doing good. So in today's video, I'll be talking about something which is very close to my heart, and by the title itself, you will have a little idea what topic is going to be about. Okay guys, I think you'll have to bear with the dogs barking in the background.
Because I have tried my best to find the most peaceful hour in the entire day. I wanted to film this video early in the morning and I thought around 5 a.m. if I wake up and film it, there will not be any noise happening around. But there is a construction going on in the next building and I thought they come by only 7 or 8 for construction work. But unfortunately, I got up at 5, took bath and I was just about to start my makeup only to realize that they have already started their drilling work. So I had no choice but to drop my plan of filming in the morning, and I thought at least in the night I'll have some peaceful time without any background noise of bikes honking or any crows or any dogs barking. But no, the dogs here don't sleep at the night also, so you'll have to bear with it.
So before I get started, I would like to tell you that if you want to go ahead and grab a snack for yourself, then please feel free to do so, because this video might get a little longer. I get very cautious when my videos are quite long because I feel that it will be consuming a lot of your time. But then it's an emotional topic, so it will be a little difficult for me to abruptly cut short the topics here and there. But yeah, if it gets a little longer, please bear with me. Go and grab a snack for yourself and I'll just get started. So yeah, in this video, I'll be first talking about what all the comments and what kind of mocking I have been through and how I worked on myself. And finally, I'll be telling you what are the things you should be doing from your end if at all you're facing this kind of situation to make sure that it doesn't affect you, and how you can make sure that you focus on the positive side of your life instead of just putting all your attention to the negative aspects. So where do I start from? I have listed down all the comments which was told by people around me, be it relatives, friends, family, batchmates, etc. at some point of time, and which has hurt me at that moment. And it's not like very unique comments which only I have received. I'm pretty sure a lot of you out there must have had people around you who would have told you some similar statements like that, because the fact is everybody out there gets mocked for something or the other in their entire life by the people around them, whether you're short, whether you're tall, whether you're thin, whether you're fat, whether you're dark, or even if you're fair, you get those kind of comments. So if you have people around you, their job is to tell something or the other. Not everybody is going to be kind-hearted and not everybody is going to be empathetic enough to, you know, realize that this might hurt the other person and just shut up. But then no, people are not always that thoughtful, and not every comment needs to have a meaning, because some comment could be something which was just told to make you feel bad, or it could be, some could be true because of the things which are out of your control. And like for example, if somebody's height is short, it's short, you don't have any control over it. But still, if the person is telling something about it, you cannot do anything about it. And I don't understand the fact, why do people even comment about such things? To tell you the truth, not every comment is always going to have a meaning. Not every comment is going to add some value to your life, or it's going to be a constructive feedback. Some comments are just told, it's just a comment, and I think it's told by the people who I feel are not empathetic enough to understand that it could hurt the other person. And maybe they are conditioned in a way where they don't realize that they are being mean, or maybe they are not taught the importance of kindness, or maybe it's just their own insecurity which is hiding behind the comment, and they thought they will just make fun of you and feel good about themselves. In short, it's impossible to find a place on this earth where people are so content with themselves enough that they don't feel that they need to poke अदर्स. आई जस्ट फील दैट अगर लोग हैं आपके आसपास तो कुछ ना कुछ तो वो कहेंगे ही. सो इट्स नॉट ऑलवेज गोइंग टू बी अ वेरी काइंड एनवायरमेंट अराउंड यू. सो यू विल हैव टू जस्ट मेक श्योर दैट यू हैव अ थिक स्किन. सी फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू आर पुट अप इन अ रूम ऑफ 10 पीपल, देन लेट मी टेल यू दैट यू कैनॉट गो अहेड एंड मेक फ्रेंड्स विद ऑल ऑफ देम एंड यू कैनॉट गो अहेड एंड इम्प्रेस ऑल ऑफ देम. इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज देर विल बी डेफिनेटली फ्यू ऑफ देम हु माइट लाइक यू, बट देन देर विल बी सम 2-3 पीपल हु माइट नॉट बी मच प्लीज विद यू एंड मे बी 1 or 2 आउट ऑफ देम विल बी somebody who would be quite mean to you also. And this room for 10 people is just a reference to your colleague, your batchmates, your friend circle, or even your cousins or relatives for that matter. And if you're assuming that you can make everyone around you happy, then let me tell you that you can do that also, but only at the cost of losing yourself, losing your peace of mind, and losing your identity. Because you would be doing certain things which you might not be able to relate with, but you'll be doing it so that they don't mock at you. Just to feel accepted and to fit in, one just tends to compromise on their own identity and spend a lot of time pretending to be somebody else and doing things which they don't really resonate with. So for these kind of scenario, all I would like to tell you is that just take a deep breath, accept it that you are what you are and you are not in charge of making everyone happy there or impressing everyone out there at the cost of your peace of mind. So basically in my case, the comments and the mocking usually happened with regards to my complexion. I was always the wheatish girl out there, so people always have some issue with a wheatish girl and they end up telling comments unnecessarily. And I was brought up in Rajasthan, and in Rajasthan you have two extreme weathers, like the summers are really hot and the winters are really cold. And I don't know, for some reason in winters my complexion would become 1 or 2 shades darker, and I don't know the science behind it. And especially the knuckles of my hand, that will have a very clear difference of shades, like here and here it will be extremely dark and it will be very much evident. I would myself know it that it's little dark, but still people would pass on a comment about that. Okay, before I start telling you the comments which I could recall, let me tell you that it was not very easy for me to go back in past and list down the points and recall those memories of being mocked at. But yeah, still I had to do it for this video so that I can let you guys know that you are not alone in this. Everybody deals with some kind of nasty comments in their life, and all that matters is you just deal with it. You just focus on something else which is more important than these trivial comments which are not going to help you anyways in life. So the first comment was one of my neighbor auntie, and she had seen me growing up, like right from the baby she had seen me. And even then, when I was, I don't know which class I was, I think I was in just 6th-7th standard, and she just casually told me that tu bachpan mein to gori thi, abhi kaise kali ho gayi. And at that point of time, it just pricked me like anything. I was just a kid and I didn't know. I just felt very embarrassed, as if there is something wrong with me. And you know what, her daughter, like the didi, she is elder to me, and her daughter was just sitting next to her, and she was like, the moment she heard her mom utter that statement, she just told me. So she wanted to stop her mom from commenting about that. And at that age, I was thinking that when a daughter can feel that it's not something which is a feel good kind of statement, how come a elderly lady can not realize that this is very mean and this is not something which she should tell to a kid? But yeah, anyway, she just chose to tell that, and I just felt really bad at that point of time, and I don't know why. Because at that point of time, when you're so young, nobody comes and tells you that these things are not that important. There are a lot of other important things in the life which you have to face and which you have to focus. But then yeah, you just tend to feel bad for the external appearances, because the people around you remind you about something which you are even not even aware of yourself. The second comment was told by one of my classmates, and we girls were just going to play, and at that point of time we just saw some cute puppies out there, and the puppy was brown in color and a little dark brown in color. Okay, I'm not being racist here, but I'm just telling you that it was a cute brown puppy. Okay, and I casually told that, wow, such a cute puppy, you know, clearly a dog lover. I was always a dog lover. I didn't realize that back then, but yeah. So the moment I completed my statement saying that, haw, kita cute hai na puppy, my friend, without giving a second thought, she just uttered a statement saying that, haan, lekin wo brown puppy bhi tujhse fair hai. And I was like, where does this statement come from, dude? Like, I was complimenting that puppy and I was admiring the beauty and the cuteness of that little baby, and out of nowhere the person had to be so mean to just tell me that the brown shade of the puppy is much lighter than mine. But yeah, I wouldn't judge her because we were too young. I think we were hardly in some 4th, 5th standard. Yeah, we were not that big. I don't feel it's her fault, because later when we grew up, I told her that you made these kind of statements. She was like little sorry about that, saying that she was young and naive and she didn't realize what she's trying to tell or what she said at that point of time. And I wouldn't blame her for this comment, because I just feel that at that point of time we were too young and naive to even understand what is right or wrong. I just feel that it's all because of the conditioning that they are so used to seeing their circle or their friends or their cousins making some lame comments like this, or taunting others or mocking at others, that they feel that there is nothing wrong in doing that to others too. So only when you see something wrong happening, often you don't find it wrong after some point. So I just felt that it was that kind of case with her. So yeah, whatever. So this was the kind of second statement which I could remember. So now let me tell you the third comment. This was again back in the school days. So in our school, we were quite active in the extracurriculars, and in one of the group song or something, I was given the role of Arjun, and there was a junior girl who was very cute and smart, and she was given the role of Krishna. So and other people were given the different roles, and we all had to perform, and the event was over. So we only had to arrange the costume and everything was done, and it was a nice event, everything done and dusted. But after a few days, a few of my friends, like, we were just walking and we were going somewhere, and just few of my friends started talking about the particular event, and one of them just questioned that why Annie was given the role of Arjun and not Krishna. I don't know why that topic came up. So they were just talking, and the girl again came and asked me and told that why you were given the role of Arjun and not Krishna. And I was like, who knows, because you don't need a qualification to get the roles, right? Teachers assign some roles and you just say yes to it, that's all. So I just told, I don't know, maybe sir thought that I should play the role, that's why he gave me, and Krishna was that girl, so Arjun had to be there, so maybe I was there, so he thought I should be doing it. Then they themselves told that you should have been given the role of Krishna, no? And to tell you the truth, in my entire school life, I have never believed or accepted that I was a beautiful person or I was a pretty person. Like, the pretty word, I had always thought it's not something to which could be my adjective. So it was like that. I had accepted it that I'm not one of the pretty girls, okay? So when these girls were discussing, and they told why you were not given the role of Krishna, so for that I told them that when the other girl is there, I mean, say for example the girl's name is A, so I just told that when A is there and she is so pretty, then why would sir give me that role? If she is not there, maybe he would have given me the Krishna's role, no? Like that, I humbly told that, okay? I was already humble. I was already bringing myself down by saying that the pretty girl is there, so maybe that's why sir would have given the role of Krishna to her. I had already degraded my own beauty. And despite that, my classmates, they were just murmuring in each other's ear. And I told, what are you guys discussing? If it's something about me, then please tell it to me, no? So one of the girls told that, no, we were just telling that how can you be Krishna, because Krishna though has to be fair, no? And I was like, dude, you guys started the topic. You had the doubt why I was not given the role. I was very happy with my Arjun role. My mom stitched the entire outfit for me, and everybody praised me so much that day, that saying that it's so perfect for the role, for the perfect for the outfit, everything is so good, you're looking good, everything. So I just was anyways happy about that entire event. And these girls, out of nowhere, after the event got over, they started discussing, and then they themselves came and asked why I was not given, and they themselves told that why I should not have been given. So yeah, so that is how it was. And again, it was proved to me that I'm not among the good looking girls, or I'm not among the fair girls. But wait a minute, there is a song, right, for Krishna, that Radha kyu gori mai kyu kala, right? So when Krishna's song itself is there, where he calls himself dark, I don't know what logic those girls used to tell me that Krishna has to be fair. So now the fourth comment. It was not about the complexion, it was more about the appearance. As I told you that I had already accepted the fact that I was not among the pretty girls, or the pretty word doesn't belong to me. So yeah, likewise the people around me also had made me believe that I was not among the pretty people. What happened was, one day my mom had made a nice French braid, and that is how I went to the school, and my teachers were all complimenting me. Like whenever I make nice hairstyles and more, teachers would compliment, because our school timings were like 7:30, and to get a nice hairstyle done, I'll definitely have to wake up early. My mom has to put in extra effort of packing my food and find time to, you know, make that special braid for me and all. So teachers would compliment the hairstyle, and in school uniform you don't have any other way to experiment, right? The uniform is going to be the same. The only way to experiment is your hair. So I would really love the days when my mom would try out different hairstyles for me, and I would flaunt it and carry it very happily, and I'll get compliments also, especially from the teachers, saying that it's very pretty and it's a very nice hairstyle and all. And I was very thankful to my mom for taking extra time for me and making that nice hairstyle for me. So yeah, one of my classmates, she just told that this hairstyle is okay. Like, what she told? She told her, this hairstyle is okay on you, but if this particular girl would have made this, it would have looked way better. Like, this particular girl means, like, according to her, whoever is the pretty girl in our class, she meant that way. So she just told that if that girl would have made this hairstyle, it would have looked really pretty. So indirectly what she meant to say was, this was a nice hairstyle, but it looks okay on me, but it would look great on somebody who is more prettier than me. So yeah, this was one of the comments, and again, it was a very young age. There is nothing to, you know, judge the people there. The girls were too young to understand what is right or wrong, but yeah, it's all about the conditioning. It's just that people around them tend to say mean comments so casually that the kids pick up from that and they don't feel that they are doing something wrong. So the fifth point is a kind of comment which I don't remember who said it when, because I keep getting it a lot of times from a lot of people, and I still get it sometimes, which I don't give a damn anymore. But yeah, this is about the outfit colors, and people have a habit of, you know, being the fashionist and the stylist out there to guide others for the choice of colors they should have the outfit based on their complexion. So yeah, a lot of people at a lot of times have told me that this particular color doesn't suit for your complexion, you should not wear these kind of light colors, it will make you look more dark, you should not wear white, it will make you look more dark, you should not wear white, who cares. So yeah, about the outfit colors, a lot of time people come and guide you for no reason without being asked. I don't know why they do that, but yeah. And who decides, man? Who decides that this particular color will suit for you and this particular color you should not wear? Like, who does that? I just don't get it. Because I feel that colors should be chosen based on the occasion and the mood. Like, for example, if I want to feel all fresh and summery, I would prefer to wear something in mustard yellow, like pastel colors like peach or light pink and all. And if I want to feel all formal, then maybe I would wear something like black, gray, navy blue or white, something like that. So the outfit color should be chosen based on the occasion instead of based on the shades of complexion you belong to. And in fact, how can I forget, even for nail polish, a lot of people tend to say that this particular color of nail polish will not suit your complexion, this will make your hand look very dark and all those things. And I still remember at one point of time that black nail polish was very much in fashion, and even that silver nail polish was very much in fashion. And I had happily bought that black nail paint because it would look really nice on everybody's hands, so I just thought I should also try it. But yeah, after I wore it, as I told you that my knuckles would be, you know, little dark, so I was not very confident. And like I told you, people will be there to comment. Somebody just told me about the complexion and the black color not going well together, so I got cautious and I had to remove it back then. Now I am at a point where I don't think too much about the colors of the nail polish. I just choose the nail polish colors based on my preference. If I like something, I like something, I buy that. If I want to wear it, I'll wear that. It's more like that. And for me, all that matters is how groomed my nails are, how neatly I have kept them. I don't prefer having the chipped nail polish all the time. So if I have that, I make sure either I remove it completely or I put a new nail polish. It's like that. For me, grooming means that. It doesn't mean that this complexion, this color, and that complexion, that color. And the sixth and the last thing is Kali word. So Kali is something which is very casually told to anybody who is not fair. Okay, if you are medium weightish, if you are little more weightish, or if you are dark weightish, no matter what competition, if you are anywhere in the weightish category, the Kali word is just used like a nickname, and I don't know for what reason, but yeah, a lot of you out there would be able to relate to it. And I am so thankful that the times are changing now. People have evolved so beautifully, especially the young people out there have evolved so nicely. Like, you can see it in our influencers itself. So many influencers out there, they make sure that they don't, you know, support something which is about brightening or skin lightening kind of products. I see the change coming from the nice young girls out there, which is a very good thing. People are becoming more empathetic, and things are changing, times are changing to an extent that even Fair and Lovely is no more Fair and Lovely, it's Glow and Lovely, because people are not ready to accept that racism which is there in the name. So these were the few comments which I could recollect, and I think I was lucky that I don't have so many negative comments to list down. I mean, these are the all the points which I could recall, maybe because these are the only points which pricked me back then. But yeah, I would say that I was so lucky that I didn't have too many bad people around me, because the points are just few. And if you are anyone out there who feel that you have got these kind of comments, then trust me, you are not alone out there. A lot of people go through these kind of meaningless comments which are not going to help them in any way. And I don't understand why people even comment that, because I don't remember even one instance where I would have mocked at anybody for anything which is out of control. Like, if it's something about the features or physical appearance or their physique, I don't remember even one instance where I would have mocked at them. Because I know the fact that it's something out of control. Like, not even in my school days I would have done it to anybody. I'm pretty sure about that. But if it's something which is under control, like if people are not disciplined, or if people forget things or they lose things, I nicely give them left and right, because I know that this is something they can work on. So I don't spare them. It's not like I don't taunt people or I don't scold people. It's just that I scold them only for the things which are in their control, which they can fix. But for these kind of things which are not in somebody's control, I don't think it's wise to make fun of them. And you know what, all these few comments which I got it despite me being good in academics and extracurriculars. Like, I feel academics and extracurriculars are very important in school life. And if you're good at that, you have a kind of respect in the school, right? Even like teachers have a respect for you, thinking that, oh, this guy or this girl, oh, she is good at sports and does well in studies too, like that. So that kind of respect is always there when you're good in these two areas. But despite me being good in that, I got these few comments. So I was just wondering that had I not been good in studies and extracurriculars, then I think the comments would have been even more, and people would have definitely found ways to mock even more. And I would have literally been the invisible person in the school. Maybe I would have hidden myself in the back bench, and I would have literally isolated myself and not spoken to anybody, because that confidence itself would not be there, because you need some kind of confidence, right? So for appearance you don't have confidence, and for studies and extracurriculars also you don't have confidence, then you will not even exist in the crowd. By the way, one funny incident just struck me. It's funny now but not funny back then. So what I used to do is I used to compare the color of my hand with the person sitting next to me. Like, I'm not sure how many of you can relate to it, especially while traveling in buses. Everybody is sitting idle and with their hands placed on the lap, right? So I would just place my hand casually next to the other person's hand, and I'll just match the complexion, like, okay, ek shade light hair, do shade light hair, like that. I know it's very lame, but then I used to do that because I was not very happy with my competition back then. So I would do this kind of comparative analysis, which was not even needed at all. And I think even until 6 years back, I did it once without realizing it. Like, I was very much in a happy place. I was very much confident about my competition. I had accepted myself completely. But then some things you're so used to doing since your childhood that it just happens naturally, right? So what happened was my friend was sitting next to me again in the bus only. And actually the nail polishes, the red colors and all would suit her a lot. And I don't know why that lame thought just came to my mind. So I just placed my hand next to her casually without her realizing that. So I was just matching, and I just realized that everything from here to here is of same color. How come her hand looks more good when she wears red nail polish? And I was just thinking how, and the moment color checking I was doing from here to here, and then I just realized, okay, my knuckles are a little dark, so maybe that's why it's not suiting. And within few seconds I just realized that I was doing this stupid comparison again, and I just told my mind to shut up and just told that, what the hell are you doing? No matter whatever is the complexion, the color, whatever you want to wear, you're gonna wear it. I just shut my mind and I just stopped that comparison right at that moment. But I just mean to tell you that some things just go with you without you wanting to carry it for long. To be honest, I feel that whether you get one such rude comment in your life or you get multiple rude comments in your life, each of it has its own role to play in breaking your confidence, in making you feel that you are not good enough, and in taking you way too far from the definition of self-love itself. And you know what? It takes a lot of effort to work on oneself, to overcome all of it, and finally become someone who accepts yourself completely for all the good things and for all the not so favorite thing of yours. So if you're someone who has come across these kind of rude comments in your life, for your physique, for your appearance, for your complexion, then let me tell you that these are not the important things which you need to really focus on, because there are a lot of other things which are important and which will make sure that your personality comes out very strongly, and this will just look very trivial in front of your strong and confident personality out there. And I'll tell you one example. In our college, like in college, we usually have our seniors whom we admire, right? So likewise, in my college, I had a lot of seniors who were like very good in their work and in sports, and the way they spoke on the stage, the way they managed the events and all those things. So I used to admire a lot of seniors, and if you ask me which particular senior was my favorite, then this girl comes to my mind, and she was, let me just tell you a description of hers. So she would be the most presentable person out there. Her dressing sense would be too good. Like any day if you want to put her in a corporate office for a presentation and meeting kind of atmosphere, her outfit will be perfect any day, because every day she would be so perfectly dressed up and everything will be on point. And the way she walked showed a lot of confidence. Her head would be always held up. The way she spoke had so much poise and so much calmness was there in her speech. And whenever she would be up on the stage, everybody would just listen to her, because the accent, the way she would say it with a command, and the way she would just say it with confidence, it would be like worth admiring. So I used to admire, like you can clearly know by now, I was a fangirl of her. So yeah, she would be perfect in her outfit. She had the beautiful collections of skirts, and every footwear of hers would match her outfit. Everything would be proper, and the speech was good, the confidence was there, and she would be always, you know, up there for all the extracurriculars, and she'll be leading the teams, managing them. A lot of hustle and bustle, and I would just say that she was worth admiring. And back then I was not somebody who would be so confident on the stage for any kind of solo speech. I had been on the stage for dance and group singing and all that, but I had never been on the stage for any solo speech, and I used to fear a lot being on the stage all alone speaking something. But later I just fixed it, and that's altogether a different topic how I did it. Maybe I'll bring it up in another video. We'll not divert and we'll not go to the other topics. This senior of ours, she was good at that too, and it's not just me who would admire her or respect her. Her own batchmates, her own seniors and juniors for sure, we all, you know, admired her and respected her for whatever she was. Because her personality was so strong and she was so confident out there that people would definitely have that respect when they see that you are so comfortable in your own skin. And you know what's the best part? She wasn't the fair-skinned girl out there. She was the perfect example of a dusky beauty. And if you think that she wouldn't have been through all these kind of mocking and these kind of rude comments from people in her childhood, then you must be wrong, because I'm pretty sure that she must have dealt it too, and she would have worked on herself to make sure that all those trivial things doesn't affect her personality, and she would have made sure that she becomes that skilled person, talented person out there who gets respected by people, and all these appearances and the competition looked very trivial because everything else was so worth admiring that the focus never went on these kind of little things which really didn't matter. So what I'm trying to tell you is that if you're cautious about your appearance, your physique or your complexion, these kind of things which are not in your control, if you're cautious about that, then you are not alone in this. Everybody goes through this. Even the most beautiful person in your circle will be having some or the other insecurity which he or she is dealing with, which you might not be aware. Even the most favorite influencer of yours must be dealing with some kind of insecurity which you wouldn't know, and you might be thinking that everybody's life is perfect. So all I'm trying to say is that make sure that you focus on the things which are in your control and take away the focus from the things which you really cannot do anything about, because the more you give your energy to the negative aspects of your life, it will only increase, it will only take away your peace. So I would just suggest that make sure that you start focusing on the positive things of your lives, on the things which you should be grateful for, on the things which you can work on, which are in your control. So just make sure that you put all your energy in the positive things and just take away all the energy from the negative aspects of your life. And to be honest, everybody out there deals with some or the other insecurity of theirs, and everybody gets judged for something or the other. And it's just that some people don't show it out openly, and some have somehow overcome it, and some would, you know, even channelize it to bring out other talents of theirs. So all that really matters is your confidence, the amount of love and acceptance you have for yourself, and how much you value your talents and skill over all these physical appearances, and how much you are willing to work on yourself, on your personality, and how much you are willing to develop the skills you have, and how thick-skinned you are. So all these factors are really important, and if you are able to focus all your attention on these important aspects, then I'm pretty sure that other little things will not bother you much. You will become that confident person out there that no matter what bad comment you come across, it's not going to ruin your day. And this is not easy. It requires constant effort. You will have to keep working on yourself. Like even till today, I definitely have few insecurities in me which I'm still working on, and I'm sure that I'll be able to overcome, like how I have overcome other issues of mine. People usually try to make other people feel low only when they know that their comments will definitely affect that person. But if you portray in a way that you have already accepted yourself however you are and you love yourself, and I don't think the other person will have guts to, you know, even come and tell you something. And even if they do, your personality would be so strong and your confidence level will be to the next level that all that would really not affect you. It will just touch you and go off, and it's not going to bother you at all. Because like as of today, if somebody comes and tells me that you're not pretty, like back in school days I never thought I was pretty, but if somebody comes and tells me that you're not very pretty, then I would just say that yeah, maybe for you I'm not pretty, but for me I am. You can call it overconfidence, but yeah, I just feel that that is how it is, because at this point of time, I really don't need anybody's certification that I'm the pretty person out there. I know however I am, I'm pretty in my eyes. So that really matters for me. Because you know what? People get intimidated by your confidence. And the moment they feel that tumhe kuch farak hi nahi padta, chahe wo kuch bhi tumhe bol de, they will feel very helpless. So the only way to fix this problem and to come out of this low feeling is just work on your personality, work on your skills, and once you become that confident person out there, the skilled person out there who is good at work, who is dependable, I'm telling you, you will see a different level of respect in the eyes of the people. And once you become this kind of person, anything you do, like even if you do anything as weird as wearing a big earring in one ear and a small earring in another ear, or trying out a very random shades of lipstick like blue or any purple or something, people might flinch for a bit, but they will not be able to comment at you or make fun of you, because your personality and your name and the respect will be so high that at this point of time they will not be having the audacity to even mock at you. And even if they do, you will have so many other people who would be loving you and respecting you that the comments of these few handful of people will not even bother you. So use this lockdown to work on yourself, your personality, your skills, and do all that you can to make yourself proud and accept every good and not so favorite aspect of yours. it wasn't easy for me to go out of my comfort zone, show my vulnerabilities and create this video, but I still did it because the only intention was that if this video can help, inspire and motivate even handful of souls out there, then I guess it's worth it. So yeah, that is it for today, and with this we come to the end of this video. I really hope you found this video useful and informative and inspiring, and if you did, then please take a moment to subscribe and also hit the bell icon and also like this video. And if you want to follow me on Instagram, then my Instagram handle will be somewhere here. I'll see you guys soon in the next video. Until then, take care. Bye.
Okay, go and sit, Babu. Later.
How much your confidence you have? No.
We'll go to next. Tukla, sit. Good color, please sit. Tukla, sit. No, please, sit. Sleep. Good tea.
Tukla, no. Become that confident person, that skilled person. Okay guys, I think you'll have to bear with the dogs barking in the background.